Hi, good morning. This is Subramanyam Jayaram Subbu. I'm going to talk about Oracle Cloud Min-Max Planning and Integration with Supplier Portal. I'm an Oracle ERP Cloud SM and Manufacturer and the Planning Consultant. And I was trained the fundamentals and the strong foundation from Nana, who is the best trainer in the world. And if you want to get any trainings on cloud and EBS, very strong foundation, you can connect with Nana. I have given the details here and his mobile number. So what is meant by min-max planning system? So why we need to use min-max and where we will go and use the min-max and how it will integrate the data with the supplier portal and what supplier will take action against those orders. So if you talk about the min-max plan system, any customers, if they are not implementing ACP or the distribution planning system, normally they will go for a min-max plan implementation. Initially at the time of go live, all the items, min-max plan values, I mean minimum value, maximum value will be given by the business. And then we will update those values along with the items and we'll load in the system. Even the cloud, what you can do means item upload FBDA template, you can put the min and max values, you can update it. Along with that, if they want to go in detail like a FLM fixed lot multiplier, minimum order quantity, maximum order quantity, yes, you can go with that. So, and later, once it's done, and later, I think after 6 months and 1 year, if they want to adjust the min and max based on the past history of supply and demand, and if he has one item, two item, yes, you can go manually go to open item in the child level, you can update it. But if it's going for a bulk, huge update for 100K items, 200K items, yes. So what you can do means there is an item, FBDA template there itself. What you can do means you can put it, update that min and max values for the same part number. You can load those in the update mode. So that's the one of the things we can do that, but in EBS, we don't have that. We need to write a custom program and we need to load those and min-max values using the item update functionality. But in cloud, we can use the FBDA template to load those items. So for this scenario, I have created a couple of items, min-max sub item one, min-max sub item two. Both are the planning method, min and max. Min-max planning, and I have taken the min and max values, and I have taken the existing Oracle inventory or legal entity business unit and supplier site, because this is the one which we're trying to do. But in real time, we can go ahead and our own legal entity, own business unit, own inventory of one supplier sites, right? And then the request over the default requesters. So let me show you these items first quickly. So how I have taken, what are the minimum parameters you need for those. So go here, I have logged into the SEM00.instructor. That's the Oracle Vizen user. Go to product management, go to product information management. And in the rightmost side, there's a task carousel. You just click this task carousel. There is something called like, you can go for browse items or manage items. Let me go for a manage items. And I can give this item start with, I'm removing one. There's a couple of items which I have created. So you can see here, this is the item one, which I created, and item two. And I have assigned this item to my inventory HC01. 00 is the master R. So if you open this item here, go to specifications and go to planning. And then you can see here, the inventory planning method, min-max planning. This is the first parameter you need to set. And last time we saw that supplier managed one. So reorder point planning, we'll see later in the differentiation, right? And then you can set your min and max values for this. And then if the business want to go in detail, if the supplier has some restrictions, this is the minimum order quantity, maximum order quantity, FLM we need to set. Yes, we can set for those values too. And then this is the replenishment type you need to set as a three types, supplier, sub-inventory, or inventory organizations. So this is the driving factor. So how you want to replenish the data. The first step is For example, supplier means it will create a purchase requisitions. If you have a subinventory means it will create only for the more order request. If it's an inventory arc means across inventory arcs to transfer the materials. IRIS will create. So this is a process normally people will do that, but again, you may ask a question. So even if you set, if you are not setting this replenishment type, but if you set this sourcing role, so a local and global sourcing role, is the system will take that sourcing role control? No, it will not take. It will, the sourcing role will not work for min-max planning system. And even though if you set the sourcing role, it will not give any impact. For example, item level is set as supplier, the sourcing role is set as a some transfer from another inventory arc, it will not work. It will not take any control for priority for that sourcing roles. The sourcing role, what it will give the use of the sourcing role here, if you set the sourcing roles properly, whenever you are creating a requisition, the supplier supply side only will take from the sourcing roles. That's the only benefit if you set the sourcing roles properly. Otherwise, there's no use of the setting for sourcing for the min max plan, right? So these are the minimum levels once you set these items. Save and close. Again, the normally this source type, normally the, here in vision they set as a org level, I mean the master org level parameter. That's the reason the child is showing as a grayed out. But normally this will be controlled with the child load. We can change the attribute control to the child because each and every inventory arc we can manage ourselves. There are some inventory arc they'll go for a sub inventory. There are some inventory arc they may go for a inventory, and there are some inventory they'll go for a supplier source type. Okay. Once you've done that, I want to go for a touchless buying purpose because once my min-max plan replenish request triggers and it will create a requisition automatically, then I don't want to go and create a manually the PO and go to process requisition creating manually PO. So system should automatically create a purchase order too. So in that case, what I did means I created a blanket agreement. Go back here, the home, and go to purchasing. Go to procurement and go for agreements. Again, if you want to learn in detail how the min-max plan scenarios will work, how the procurement process, configuration, everything, you have to go and talk with Donna. He will train you in detail how you'll do the process, everything. So procurement, order management, and inventory, all the modules. And just click here, tasks, cursor, and go for these manage agreements. If you go for a manage agreement, I have created one BPA, blanket purchase agreement 3064. I'm taking this agreement number here. Click fine, search. And this is my agreement, it's already approved. Just open this agreement. And I go for this supplier, the existing supplier and supplier site. And this is the person, Jamie Ryan is my supplier contact, right? This is the minimum requirement here. And I put these two items here. Just one item is $60, one is $75, right? This is the next level's configuration I did. Now I'm going and running the min-max plan and we'll see how it'll get replenished, right? And I'll open another window. I'll go into tools, schedule, process. The request name is print min-max planning report. Schedule new process and print before doing this I just missed one setup. Let me do that too because I want to link this PIM items to my vendor manage, I mean the supplier portal. If you want to appear all the data directly in vendor portal, what you need to do means you have to go back into supply chain collaboration. So supply chain planning, supply chain collaboration. Go to supply chain collaboration and then go here, task carousel. You have to set that VMI network. Again, this is the VMI network, the relationship with the same what we did for the VMI session 2. I'm just going to click here and organization, the supplier, BA Medicals, And supply cycle will come by default. And item is, let me take this item here. And you can see this is the enterprise. Excuse me. So the default min-max quantity sources enterprise is nothing but the supplier is not the right person to decide what is my minimum and maximum quantity. So this will be decided by the buying organization, the warehouse person over in the maintaining warehouse manager, he will take care of. That's the reason it got grayed out. So enterprise, and it'll give some the default requester here. If you go for a VMI process, it will show you that the min-max quantity source will be open and it will show as an enterprise or the supplier. It means that who plan to control the min-max value for the vendor managed inventory. For all vendor managed inventory, normally we'll give the min-max quantity source, we'll give it to the supplier. Supplier will handle that. Last time we saw the session how to upload that min-max quantity also. So create, save and create another. I'll create for another item too. And I'll go for the next item. And the same configuration here. Excuse me. So once you're done this, you can see here, and then this setup is done. So once this setup is done, you can see these part numbers in vendor site. Let me log into vendor. I'll open different browser. So Jamerian, this is the password. I already used this one. So I went to supplier portal. I went to manage inventory. And then I'll go for something called like, let me search my part numbers. So, oops. We'll take these part numbers, search, so I'll go for another valuation out of stock, search. Can say S22 min max sub item 1, S22 min max sub item 2, right? So these are the items which I'm going to see. Or if you want to see only for stock is out of stock. And again, before going that, you can see in stock, if it's in stock, if you have out of stock, there's no stock, out of stock. And there are some scenarios to show as a stock above maximum. So these all the values, you can see the status also. So I can filter only for out of stock. I want to see what are the part numbers. If these are the two items which I created, S22 min max sub item 1, S22 min max sub item 2, which are out of stock. It means there is no on and there is no order quantity also. Because, but if you see here in the right side, it shows my minimum and maximum quantities here. Right? I'm going to run the min max plan to replenish this right. So I'm going here into my another browser. Oops. And going to process scheduling process and just schedule new process. Print min max planning report. Click OK. And then you can give this organization. So 01 sort by item, and you can give this item. Let me give first item and second item, only two items. I don't want to go for all the items. And then the planning is a organization level, and come down little bit, and you can see there is something called default cutoff date, demand cutoff date, and supply cutoff date. Normally what they'll do means, so what level in my horizon, right? Planning horizon. So how much demand I want to take for last 3 months, still last 3 months demand I need to consider as my demand. 2 month demand, do I need to consider? Most of the companies, what they will do means they'll take the 90 days, like a 3 month demand as a plant. And then accordingly for that 3 months demand, they will, if any supply is not exist, they will create a requisitions for that, because based on my lead times, there are some parts may not come immediately, we can't able to procure. If you raise a purchase order based on the supplier lead time, it will take a 1 month or 2 months too. And the same way we can consider our supply also. For example, I raise a sales order today. The sales order need to fulfill mostly next month, 1st of April. Today is 15th March. If you want to March, I don't want to go and procure the material now, but I want to see, is there any supply is coming into my inventory on 1st of April, before 1st of April. If any supply is coming, then I need to consider that source as a supply. I don't want to raise any requisition. For that, what they will do means they'll give this a supply cutoff date. Supply cutoff date is which date, or they'll give something like a cutoff date offset, date offset 90 days, supply cutoff date offset 90 days, or here they'll give 90 days. And then the restock option, yes, we already know, sir, that the same functionality, whatever EBS, if it's S, then it will get replenished. If no, means you can see only for the report. And then again, this is all supply and demand, which we need to consider, which not, but make sure to keep as it is S, a default values as per Oracle is provided. And then you just click submit. I'm just going a min-max is a little bit high level, because I'm not going in detail, because it was already this min-max. If you want to learn how it will work, coordination level, supply level, subventor level, none has given the training for those. Min-max is almost a 1 hour session. So you connect with Nana if you want any details about the min-max planning. So once this got run, this report succeed. Just you can see the output here too. Go here down, output, republish, and open here field, and PDF or XML, whatever you want to open it. Open. And this is my batch ID. Then you go down, you can see there are 12. This is my reorder quantity, 240, another one is 200. Because it's my zero. So my on hand is zero, my supply quantity zero, demand quantity zero, available quantity zero. The available quantity is nothing but on hand plus supply minus demand. That's the formula. Based on that calculation, it will provide this available quantity. And then based on that available quantity system, we'll do the reorder quantity. Whatever available quantity we need for that, the reorder quantity. And the min and max values, whatever we set item level here. So this is the report is showing here. Once you run this report, normally in EBS, immediately it will transfer the data from inventory to purchasing requisition interface tables. And then when you run the rec import, automatically that will be converted as a purchase requisitions. And then based on that setup, it will create a purchase orders. But in cloud, slightly different. Once you run the min-max plan report too, normally what we need to do means we need to run another program which need to load the data from inventory to supply chain orchestration process. The supply chain orchestration here is nothing but it's like an interface. I mean, there is a middleware which will integrate the data between across the modules, like inventory to purchasing to inventory, or order management to inventory, order management, manufacturing to inventory, manufacturing to inventory, inventory to purchase orders, or planning system to purchasing. So this is like an interface, but normally in EBS, if you want to see any interface data, you have to go back in tables, you have to see that. But here, and you have, if you want to resubmit and you have to write some script, you have to submit and you have to rerun that programs. But in cloud, yes, you can see everything in this visually in the system, I mean the front end. And then if you have any data, it gets stuck in the interface, you can correct the data in the front here itself, in the supply chain orchestration itself, and then you can resubmit it. That's one of the amazing feature in cloud. Everything is trackable with visually, and there are many KPIs also exist in that supply chain orchestrations. Let me run this program and show you the supply chain orchestration. There's a program name called like supply, process, supply chain orchestration interface. Resubmit. You can see, you can submit the process supply chain orchestration interface with this argument SC01, yes. I have taken the existing program and I have to resubmit it. I haven't created a new scheduled program. So we'll wait for a minute. But still the program is running. You see, they still is running. Let it complete. So it got completed. Now what you'll do means we'll go back again here in the home screen. I'm still in the SCM00 instructor. This guy has a full access. And then they go for a supply chain execution and something called like a supply orchestration. Just open supply orchestration. And again, this is, you can see in the, when you open, immediately the day, whenever the process happen, it will show in this overview page, supply lines overview itself. You can see what is my supply type, is a buy or make a transfer. Normally mine is a buy because I am creating a requisition, purchase requisition buy in the procurement. So that's the reason supply type is showing buy. And these are the S22 min max of item one, S20 min max of item two. This is my two items within on track. Other than that, if you want to go back again to details, go here, manage supply lines. If you go to manage supply lines, and then if you have that item, I want to go for start with on this item search. So you can see here, there are two items. There are two lines. It came from Oracle Fusion Inventory Management. It's my source type. So inventory to, I'm pushing to purchasing module. And it'll show everything, the requested quantity, everything it will show here. And this is my, the min-max planning batch numbers. So it will show data. If you want to go in detail again, see, just click the supply order here. The supply order has the two lines, 1.1 and 2.1. And you can see here, this is the number. And you can see in the down, something like a buy. This is my purchase requisition number. I'll put it here. And you can see make and transfer, it will be blank because if any make and transfer orders, then it will show in the details here. So buy items here, requisition got created. And the same way you can see in the line two also, this is the another requisition. The reason why you can ask a question why it got created two requisitions, because I put that group by as an item in the min max plan. That's the reason it show, it's created two requisitions. If the group by is a different, have taken like a supplier side category, then it may create a single requisition, group the two lines together, right? Then you go back in orchestration plan and go to the execution document. And you see here. So once you've done this, so I'm going to see my, the requisition numbers in the system. So done, click done. Because if you go and see in the supplier right now, so you may not get this detail here. So because the supplier portal, the data will come only whenever this, the purchase order got created. You mean, I have already created a purchase requisition. I have created my purchase, BP also against this order. So due to that reason, when the purchase requisition got created, then automatically it may be created a purchase order too. So we're going to see that. So go to procurement. I'll go directly in the purchase orders. And you'll go to task cursor, go to manage orders. If you go manage orders, there's a functionality here. You can give this requisition number. So I have this, my requisition number. I'll give this requisition number, what is the P1 number? Search. This is my P1 number, which got created. And it's a open means it's a approach status. And I'll go for this requisition number, I'll see. But In EBS, if you have requisition number, if you go to purchase order, you can't able to see that. If you want to track the PO, from the requisition only you need to track the PO. So vice versa here. Yeah, both the ways is possible here in cloud. Manage orders and give the requisition number here. Click fine, search. So you can see another, this is the PO. Created because of the group by items I have done, then that's the reason it's created two requisition, two POs. So it's done now. So open. Now what I can do means I'll go and see in my supplier portal. So now the stock came, right? So I don't have, need to filter this, but I can filter based on these items. Search. Something like advance. Search. So I think I need to show both the items now. So let me go here, search. Instead of equals, I start with, so go for item, right? So I'll give search. So these are the two items which are using. You can see right now it's in green. It means in stock. In stock because this already PO got created. PO got created, it came to the supplier. That's the reason it's showing in stock. And the purchaser quantity, first one is showing 240, another one is showing 200. And then if you want to see what are the POs, then the same way you click this 200, you'll go and see this PO numbers, PO details. Right? So click done. So now the supplier need to take a call that he want to create a ASN because he is ready to ship the details. He already knows he got the PO numbers, everything. He's going to ship that product to the vendor. He can select multiple lines at the same time. Oops. Go to actions. So there is something called like if you select multiple lines, this view item details, review item transaction will be grayed out because multiple items you can't able to open the screen. If you go for a single line, you can able to see that. Again, this upload min-max quantities, upload replenishment request, those are not eligible for if the item is a min-max item. This more are related to vendor managed inventory, but somehow the Oracle didn't fix properly this issue. I already raised this issue in the recommendations like innovations place in the customer connect. Maybe I think Oracle may consider this change. And then they did it properly for this create replenishment request because this is a min-max. The supplier not eligible to create any replenishment request. That's the reason. The same way they have to do this too also, but somehow they missed it. So now let me go for a single item, single line. Go here, actions. You can see here, view item details, review item transactions, all the details are there. If you click the view item details, so you can see all these details, what is the request date and PO number, everything. If you click the PO, again, it will take you into this PO screen and it will show you the details, purchase order details. So everything will be shown here in this purchase order details. Click done. Done. So now I'm going to create a ASN for both the lines. Create ASN. So I have for this one, min max of item 2, min max of item. So this is all the my items, not that ones. These are my items. Create ASN. So you can go for the S22 min max. Yes, and then you can give the shipment date and the expected receipt date. For example, if in transit 2 days, the supplier can able to give the expected shipment date and you can give the other details too. And then go here and fill this quantity, 200 quantity, you go into ship 200 quantity. Here, instead of 240 quantity, you can go and ship this something called like 150 quantity. Whatever the quantity is going to ship, then submit. So this ASN got created with lines, two lines. Click OK. Done. You got interfaced. Then once it's done, go back again, search, and then you click. I'm going here, start with, click search. So now, previously we saw that the data is in the purchase order quantity. Now it moved to in transit quantity. Like before it was showing is 240, like 150 plus 90. Now only 150 quantity I'm shipping it now. Still the 90 quantity is open. And later I think supplier can able to ship this 90 quantity too. And then in transit is showing is 150 and 200. Again, once this ASIN is received in inventory, it will show that 150 is moved to received quantity. And then 200 and more to received quantity. So that's all. We have seen this processes of how to create AS, how to receive the ASIN, and then we'll come back and seeing the receiving quantity in the last session. So the same functionality here also. So this confirms that even the supplier portal, if you have access in cloud, even the supplier can able to view what is that orders, everything. And visually they can see that, and it's a tight integrated. You don't need to run any custom programs to or any interface collection generator and to push the data from source system to buying organization system to supply system. And then again, the recent activities in the last 30 days, you can see here. And if you click here, you can see that. And the same transaction amount, what is that report? You can see the reports also here, how much valuation. And you see how many agreements are for the supplier. For example, if you click agreement open, there are two agreements which I created for yesterday, one for testing. And today we have created one more agreement. And how many total orders they have and replenishments. So 3064 is one agreement which I have today. 3064, which is related to these two items. And if you click this 3064, it will open that agreement lines, everything. Right? This is the one. So that's how the supplier also can able to tightly, he can able to track all the details, what exactly the buying organization side is going on. And what is the minimum and maximum quantity whenever if the buyer or the planner is going to change min max quantity based on their supply and demand, fast supply and demand, the immediately the min and max quantities will get reflected to the supplier portal too. So that's how there's no conflict between the supplier and the buying organization, and always it'll be sync. So this is the best one of the functionality which is exist in the cloud system. So feel free, if you have any questions, contact me and I can able to answer your questions. Thank you.